All right, so I'm going to show you something in the new snapshot with villagers. A bit of a secret, if you will, that I probably wouldn't have noticed myself if I hadn't seen it pointed out on Reddit. So, with this guy here, you'll notice on his texture, he's got a little thing that you might otherwise completely ignore down here on his waistband. I don't know if you'd call it a belt buckle or a pendant or what he's got hanging off there, but right now it's kind of blends in. It's gray, right? So this is our librarian, which, thank goodness, we can just tell right away based on the new texture. And I'm gonna give him a trade real quick here, okay? And he's gonna level up, assuming that he feels nice about it. And you might notice, okay, a little bit of a change there. It's gone from being completely grayed out to more of a bronze color, right? So we'll move on to the next trade, say. Throw 10 books in there, get another emerald out of it. He should, because it's a new trade, do a level up. And now we have a gold thing compared to the gray on the original one. It stands out a little bit more. It just blends in kind of with his coat that he's wearing on the librarian. But in this case, you'd see it a bit better with our cartographer. Are you jealous? Are you jealous that you don't look the same as him anymore? Because he's got this dope outfit going on. And all you've got to show is that, I mean, the gold monocle is actually pretty cool. I'll give you that much. Then let's move along a little bit more. What should we trade? We'll do the emerald for gold trade, which is not gold, it's glass. Actually, I was just distracted by the pendant down there. And then, what do you know? He levels up again, and we get a green emerald thing. Isn't that cool? And then let's go all the way down here. We'll do the book trade. Let's see, would this have been a good trade? Channeling, if you had a trident and you wanted it, would have been not too bad. And finally, that should unlock the last tier, and it goes to diamond, which is very interesting to me, actually. Because you sometimes consider emerald as being like a step above diamond, wouldn't you? Even though you obviously can't make tools out of it. But this kind of confirms diamond is the highest tier in Mojang's eyes. So we've solved a couple of mysteries here. A, what tier this guy is by looking at him. And B, that diamond is apparently as high as it gets. Unless, hold on, can we go further here? Because sometimes they get a little name tag enchantment at the end. But maybe you don't have that. I think it varies from library. Oh, there we go. Okay, so you're getting another level, but I guess diamond remains the highest, because I was trying to think, what would you possibly get after that? Obsidian or something? No, so it remains diamond, even if you get the last name tag after that. Now you might be thinking, okay, it doesn't really have that much of an impact on me, because in the village that I'm at, kind of only have one librarian anyway, so I know what his trades are, and it's not really a big deal. Well, let me show you it in practice. Hey, so here's a place we haven't been in a while. In fact, well, pretty much never on this channel. This is the Deep End server. Since I haven't been in here in a while, I don't actually know if there's a bunch of new stuff going on. But this is something that's going to be really helpful to me personally. Now that the server is working again, if you've followed the series over on the Captain Sparkles 2 channel, it's been a while because the new snapshots caused chunks to have loading issues and it was basically unplayable for several weeks. But now, apparently it's all good, and with the added new villager tweaks, it's actually gonna be kind of the best thing ever. So I'm gonna turn off my volume here really quickly so that I don't hurt your ears. And here is our villager farm. This is amazing. Okay, so now, not only do I know exactly what a librarian is, but I can look at its belt and I see, okay, I've leveled this one up all the way. Great, I don't need to worry about you, because I've already unlocked, I know what's in you, and you don't have a good mending trade for 15 emeralds or less, because why would you do that? And then I can come over to you. Okay, you're fully leveled up. You, okay, you have green. It means you're not fully leveled up. So you have another thing that I can do a trade for and unlock one final book that it could be mending. Whereas previously it was like, okay, I'm gonna click on you. Are you, you're a cartographer. God dang it. That's, I don't care about you. I click on, oh, you're a cart, God dang it. You're a librarian? All right, let me scroll all the way. Oh, wait, you're unlocked fully. Ugh. And so it was like this trial and error process of trying to find who I hadn't actually fully unlocked all the way so I could see if I am able to get a mending trade. Now I can just look, though. You're fully unlocked. You need another unlock. You need another unlock. You do, too. All you three need more unlocks. So see, I just need to go get some more emeralds or glass or what have you to do the trade. Stop looking at me like this. No one, see, we don't care about the butchers. Because, I mean, I can get emeralds that way, but I don't really have much of a farm because on this series, people have killed my animals and not replenished them. It's kind of like not re-racking your weights at the gym. They kill the animals and don't replenish. This is why it's great in practice, is that now it's going to save so much time. I'm going to know who I need to walk up to, and that's that. And I know the difference between librarians and cartographers. Like, this is fantastic. And I didn't even realize until having it pointed out that this thing tells you what level of unlock the villager is. And even if I had come on here, I still probably wouldn't have paid attention. I don't think I would have realized the difference. I would have been like, oh, they just have different textures to give more variety, not realizing that it actually signifies something. And so when we go over to all of our villagers over here who are fully unlocked, should be able to see if they are all there. Okay, see a little bit blue over here. These are all going to be diamond guys because these are the ones that we've actually traded with in order to get particular trades. So they're all the way unlocked, pretty much all of them. I don't know if these guys over here are because just use them to get carrots, but I've probably traded enough carrots and potatoes with these guys that they fully unlocked. Yep, they're up to diamond. So anyway, that's the use in full form with a villager farm, and it's the best. I can't tell you how big of a pain in the butt it was to deal with this. If you've ever watched the series, which if you haven't, it's a lot of content for you to check out over on Captain Sparkles 2, so feel free to do so. And if you've ever watched it, you know how big of a struggle this room always was. Until now, it's great. All right, well, I just wanted to let you guys know about it in case you've shared similar struggles with your own villager farm. And, yeah, whew, what an improvement. Just make sure you turn off your volume because it's very loud in there. Anyway, thanks for watching. Probably the best feature to have been added in this new snapshot. Faster smelting, that's great and all, but that's a personal headache of mine. So anyway, we'll wind it down. More of a quick video this time around, but what it lacks in length, it makes up for in quality. Yes, that was what he said. Okie dokie. Make sure to like if you like. Check out the playlist in the description if you've missed any update-related things and want to catch up on them. Subscribe if you're not already. And I'm going to go home. A lot of cake still. I'll see you next time.